sex appeal diet. Is it for real? Kim Ruby is a certified nutritionist, and she's here to talk about whether certain foods can actually change your sex life. Good morning.
Good morning.
How you doing?
Great. Thanks
okay,
for inviting.
Okay, we should have people's attention by now. A new book out is talking about how you don't necessarily need Viagra or whatever it is. You can actually have, you know, a banana instead.
Well,
is that true?
Well, kind of. Dr. Stephen Lamb, an internist from New York City, he wrote a book on Viagra, and now he wrote a book called The Hardness Factor. Mm-hmm. And he believes there are six steps to increase a gentleman's libido. The book will be out May 31st, perfect time for Father's Day. And he does have six steps, and I'd like to take you through them very
quickly.
Let's do it.
I'm sure people are paying attention.
Sexual performance, he believes, is greatly impacted by the diet. So sexual nutrition seems to be quite a topic. He also wrote some abstracts on natural herbs to increase nitric oxide and arginine. And then also, the second thing that he believes is that a man should decrease his food intake by about 10%. And he believes that less fat in the body significantly increases the testosterone level. He also calls things like saturated fat erection enemies. And I got these from your break room.
Oh, no.
Only men were picking
No wonder
these
the libido is bad at the KUSI studio. It's the cinnamon rolls.
He says avoid fatty foods. Penile nerves lose sensitivity when your cholesterol builds up.
Really?
And, of course, there's extra virgin. Now, the truffles. I believe the truffles are actually, for you and I, a libido enhancer. But that's a different segment.
I do, too. So you take them. He can't have them.
Sorry.
Because of his penile nerve issue.
Right. Okay, and, of course, he talks about extra virgin. Extra virgin
right,
olive
extra
oil.
Right, extra virgin, yes.
Which is a wonderful fat.
Mm-hmm.
And then he says we should lower our cholesterol. The gentleman should lower their cholesterol to combat cardio disease, which increases blood flow. It's all about increasing blood
flow
to cardio and other areas.
Yes.
So he recommends 9 servings of fruits and vegetables a day.
I like it.
And then here's an antioxidant green tea. We all know the benefits of antioxidants being cell protectors.
Okay, what about this this fish right here, which is really smelling very special this hour of the morning?
Sorry about that. This is called the hardness-friendly dinner. Right, hardness-friendly dinner. He believes that along with your volcano chocolate cake and your oysters, that you shouldn't have alcohol before you eat. And he believes you should train like an athlete before being involved.
Really?
Yes, yes. Treat it as
before
performance.
Before being involved. I love this. I love how you have to dance around this and not me. Right?
And he says that split the meal with your partner.
Right.
And don't have heavy saturated fats.
Right, which makes sense because when you're full, you don't, you know, you may not feel like, you know, engaging.
So, the book is an interesting title.
Yes, it is. And yeah, the hardness factor, that is too funny. And garlic.
Garlic, spice it up.
Right, spice it up.
Chili peppers, ginger, spice it up, increasing circulation, and all again, it is about circulation.
Okay, great. All right, so again, all of these foods, we'll pan you down the list here, all these foods.
Except
these.
Except this. This is a no-no.
Yeah, that is a, what did you call that again?
Erection enemy, number one.
Erection enemy. All right. This is news you can use, really. Thank you so much for
your
time this morning. We appreciate
Thank
it.
Thank you.
Very good job. I don't think we offended anybody.
I hope not.
I hope not, anyway. That was our goal.